Hi there, I'm Axon, and welcome to today's tutorial on how to quickly craft a certificate in Google Docs. We're gonna cover how to download a certificate template, customize it with your own wording, and save it in PDF. So if you're looking for a way to commemorate a certain achievement of your students, or maybe you want to prepare something special for all the people who attended your webinar, by the end of this video, you're gonna learn how to do all of that in a form of a certificate that we're gonna design together in Google Docs. One last thing before we get started though, if you're looking for a professional certificate maker that will help you design and send all your certificates completely for free, you definitely need to check out Certifier. We have a plan that allows you to issue up to 250 certificates completely free of charge, so if you're interested in checking it out, sign up for free at certifier.io. And now, let's finally get to our Google Docs tutorial. Now, once you're signed into your Google account, the first thing you need to do is to find yourself free editable certificate templates in Google Docs. And that place is called certifier.io/templates. As you can see, there are many, many different templates. All of them are available in many different formats like Figma, PowerPoint, Google Slides, Canva, Word, Google Docs, and all of them are absolutely free. On the left side, you can actually see different categories like recognition, training, and course, which means that you will definitely find here a certificate template that will fit your agenda and style. Since we are here for a specific purpose, and that is to find Google Docs certificate templates, I'm gonna go ahead and click on this tag right here. What it did, it filtered out all the certificate templates that were not available in Google Docs format. As you can see, all of the certificate templates right here have a Google Docs icon below them, which means that they're available in this format. I think I'm gonna go ahead and click on this certificate recognition right here. As you can see, it is available in different orientations. We have a landscape one and a portrait one. Apart from different orientations, it comes in different colors, like brown, black, or this green one. I'm gonna go ahead and click on this brown one. From this point, you can either use this template right now in Certifier or download it in Google Docs. I'm gonna go ahead and click on this Google Docs icon right here. And what this will do is actually offer you to make a copy of this exact Google Docs to your own Google Drive. I'm gonna go ahead and click on Make a Copy. And what it did specifically, it added this certificate template to my own Google Drive. You can check it if it's actually there by going to drive.google.com. And as you can see, this is the only document I have in my drive. So this is exactly the certificate template that we just made a copy of. Now I'm gonna come back to this Google Docs document. First things first, let's go ahead and check what is the size of this certificate template. Let's go to the file, page setup. As you can see, the paper size is defined at A4. What is worth noting is that all the certificate templates that you can find on certifier.io come in predefined A4 proportions. So it doesn't matter whether it comes to landscape or portrait formats, all of them are in A4 format. Now at this point, we can actually start customizing our certificate template. I'm gonna go ahead and add my own title. To do that, just select the element that you want to change and click on edit right here. A new pop-up menu will appear. And to choose the element that you want to change, just select it. I'm gonna go ahead and select the entire second line here and start typing in off appreciation. Now at this point, I'm not quite happy with the size of the font. So I'm gonna go ahead and select the entire second line, go to the upper tab and change the font size from 15 to 22. Now, as you see, the text adjusted accordingly. Now I'm gonna go ahead and click on save and close to preview my change. As you can see, the title of our certificate has been automatically adjusted. Now, you might have noticed that we didn't have to install any additional fonts or anything like that. That's because all the fonts used in Certifier certificate templates come from Google Fonts, which is an open source database available to anyone. So you definitely don't have to worry about copyright issues. Now, the next step is to try and add in a recipient name. I'm gonna go ahead again and select the element and click on edit right here. And I'm gonna double click on all the elements and start typing in the name that I want to change it to. I'm gonna go ahead with Matthew Jones. And then just proceed to save and close, and the element that you've just changed will be automatically updated. Now, next thing to do is to change the description. As you can see here, we have some lorem ipsum. I'm gonna go ahead and change it. Click on edit right here. And let's start typing in whatever we want. You can triple click on the text to select all of it, or you can use the shortcut command A to select the entire text. Now I'm gonna start typing in for major contribution to marketing campaigns in September of 2023. Now, I'm not quite happy with the font size right here, so I'm gonna go select the entire text, go to the font size tab right here and change it to 20. Now I'm gonna go ahead and save and close it to preview. As you can see, our description has been updated automatically. Now, next thing on our list is to update the names of the people that will be signing our certificate. As you can see here, we have two authorities. One is the CEO, the other one is the director. I don't think I will be needing two people to sign my certificate, so I'm just gonna go ahead and select the element and click delete on my keyboard to get rid of it. Same goes with the position. Now, when it comes to the name of the person that will be signing my certificate, I'm gonna go ahead, edit it, and choose it to be Andrew Marshall. Now, you might have noticed that the text went to the second line. That is because our text box had predefined width. But this is no problem because we can just take it and drag it to the right and it will be adjusted accordingly. Now, in terms of the position of Andrew Marshall, I'm gonna go ahead and change it to regional manager. Save and close. Let's update the issue date from 2021 to 2023. Save and close as well. Now let's change the issue certificate ID. Since this is our first certificate that we'll be issuing, I'm gonna go ahead and change the last three digits of the certificate ID to 001. You might have noticed that there is a lovely icon of the badge right here. To your surprise, this element is editable as well. You can change it and write whatever text you prefer. I'm gonna go ahead, select the entire element and type in good job. Save and close. Now, one of the last things to do before we try to export the certificate template is to personalize it with your own company logo. I have already prepared a logo of a small bookstore that I wanna insert into this certificate template. First things first, let's get rid of this placeholder that we don't need. Just select the entire element and click delete on your keyboard to get rid of it. Now let's go to the insert, image, upload from computer. As you can see here, I have prepared a logo of my little bookstore called Hometown Reads. You might have noticed that my logo is actually in a PNG format, which means that it doesn't have any background. I'm just gonna double click on it and it will appear on my certificate. Now, one of the things to do is to select in front of text so that this element won't be in conflict with other graphical elements on your certificate template. And now use these tools to resize it and reposition it whenever you want. As you can see, Google Docs also has align prompts in the form of these red lines that will help you to align your elements perfectly with respect to other elements. Now, at this point, I think I'm quite happy with the result. So let's explore what are the options, what we can do with the certificate to get it to our recipients. One of the first things that you can do is to try to email it. Just go to the file, email, email this file. Here you will be able to type in the name of your recipient, add the subject of this email and some text and choose the file type. As you can see here, it's predefined as PDF, meaning that your recipient will receive this exact certificate in a PDF format to his or her mail. Another option that you can explore is to go to the file and try to download it in different formats. I think I'm gonna go ahead with PDF. Now I'm gonna go ahead and rename the name of the certificate to Certificate of Appreciation. And I'm gonna click Save it. Now let's check out how our certificate turned out to be. As you can see, everything was saved correctly. We have our logo, our new title, our new recipient name, description, the name of the person that will be signing our certificate, issue date, certificate ID, and our lovely badge. Now, from this point, you can actually go ahead and print the certificate to hand it to your issuing authority for him or her to sign. Actually, one of the interesting things is that if you click on more settings right here, you already see that the paper size is predefined in A4 format, which will make sure that your certificate is printed correctly. So that wraps up our tutorial. Hopefully you learned that Google Docs can be used to personalize your certificate templates, but there are certain limitations when it comes to generating and sending many certificates in bulk. And that's where Certifier comes in and helps you to automate the entire operation. So if you have multiple recipients that you're trying to get your certificates to, Certifier would be the best tool to use. It's easy, incredibly user-friendly, and absolutely free. If you're a fan of another Google Drive app like Google Slides, we have a tutorial on how to create certificate templates there as well. So again, if you want to sign up for free, go ahead and click the first link in the description down below. Thanks for watching, and I see you in the next one.